If you're a longtime fan of country music, then you've witnessed how some of your favorite singers have changed over the years. And while their looks have evolved, that's not the only way that these big names have become unrecognizable. Reba McEntire has been on the scene for quite a long time. She's been active in the industry since the 70s, and she's definitely changed a lot since then. While she's still rocking her signature red hair as always, that doesn't mean she hasn't grown over the course of her career. She landed her first record deal back in 1975, and since then, she's racked up a number of accolades, including multiple Grammys and American Music Awards. She's also established herself as an actress on the big and small screens, as well as the Broadway stage. Decades may have passed since McEntire first joined the music world, but this queen of country has no plans to slow down anytime soon. Shortly after she turned 64 in 2019, she told People magazine, "I feel 35, maybe 40. Used to be 60 years and one foot was in the grave. Now maybe 85 is one foot, maybe 95. She also noted that she gets her youthful spirit from her mother, who, even in her 90s, was spunky and frisky. Tim McGraw has made a name for himself not only as one of the biggest stars in country music, but also as one half of a power couple. He's been married to his wife, fellow country star Faith Hill, since 1996, and he's come a long way since his Bachelor Country Star days. Nowadays, his family is a big part not just of his home life, but of his career as well, as he and Hill have been known to record and go on tour together. As McGraw told People magazine in 2018, his relationship with Hill, quote, poured gasoline on both of their careers.
And I looked at her and was smitten right away, yeah.
And do you remember falling in love with him too? Do you remember falling in love?
No, she didn't fall in love with me right away.
McGraw is also focused on his children, although he and Hill make sure to prioritize date nights for some alone time. He told Taste of Country in 2019 that as much as he loves their three daughters, he's also excited to see them eventually move out and start their own careers. Randy Travis all but retired from music in 2013 when a stroke left him with limited speech and took away his ability to use the right side of his body. Despite this, he's remained optimistic and an inspiration to everyone else. In 2019, he released a book, Forever and Ever, Amen, a memoir of music, faith, and braving the storms of life. As his wife Mary told USA Today, Randy lived the colorful life. You don't have to embellish it. That colorful life includes 16 songs that hit number one, an incredible feat that cemented Travis's name in country music history forever. To top it off, he's also won 6 Grammys and 6 CMA Awards. While he may never regain full control of his voice, he hasn't let that stop him. In 2016, he performed Amazing Grace at the Country Music Hall of Fame medallion ceremony. He also keeps busy with book events, interviews, and business meetings. And in 2019, he went on a short tour with his band. His songs were performed by James Dupre, while Travis joined in a little. In 2020, Mary Travis told Cowboys and Indians magazine, "We're still singing. It's just a different type of song now." Carrie Underwood first charmed the world when she competed on the 4th season of American Idol in 2005. While winning the show catapulted her to fame, she's admitted that she very nearly didn't audition for the opportunity that would prove to be her big break. While she had always wanted to be a country music singer, she didn't think she stood a chance. As she told BBC Radio in 2019, that was dreaming too big. Fortunately, Underwood's mom convinced her to go through with the audition, and the rest is history. The year after winning Idol, she won her first Grammy and now has several more under her belt. It's hard to believe that the young woman who didn't think she had any hope of even making it onto a singing competition is now a household name. Underwood can hardly believe her luck either. In 2018, she got a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame and said at the ceremony, "How is this my life?"
I've been so blessed in my life to have so many people who have... Crap, I'm crying!
Josh Turner rose to prominence in the early 2000s with his hit single Long Black Train. He was still just in college when he wrote the song that would turn him into a star. Turner has lost his baby face since his early days on the country music scene, but he's no less handsome today than he was all those years ago. He's always been motivated by his Christian faith, which inspired him to release the gospel album I Serve a Savior in 2018. He told Entertainment Focus that he'd been wanting to branch out into gospel for quite some time, even though establishing himself as a country performer had been his main goal. I Serve a Savior showed off Turner's versatile voice, and also showcased his family. The album includes a live version of the song The River of Happiness, which was co-written by Turner's wife Jennifer and his son Hampton, and features vocals from all 4 of Turner's sons. Trisha Yearwood is an unstoppable force. She rose to fame in the 90s after she released her self-titled debut album in 1991. The lead single, She's in Love with the Boy, hit number one. From there, she went on to tour with fellow legend Garth Brooks, whom she later married, and churned out multiple hits and platinum records over the course of the decade. She's earned several Grammys, and she was inducted into the Grand Ole Opry in 1999. Yearwood branched out from music in the 2000s as she penned the cookbooks Home Cooking with Trisha Yearwood, Georgia Cooking in an Oklahoma Kitchen, and Trisha's Table. In 2012, she began hosting the cooking show Trisha's Southern Kitchen on Food Network. And in 2019, she made a return to music with the album Every Girl, which was her first solo record since 2007. Is there anything she can't do? LeAnn Rimes' talent was evident from a young age, as she won her first singing competition at the age of 5. She then got her start in the music industry at the tender age of 13, with her chart-topping cover of the Bill Mack song Blue, which set her on the path to becoming a country music icon. Rimes' talents go beyond music, as she's also a charming actress with several credits under her belt, including the 2000 film Coyote Ugly, in which she played herself. Hallmark fans also surely know Rimes well. She made her debut with the network in 2018's It's Christmas Eve, which she also executive produced. In addition to acting and singing, Rimes is focused on family life with her husband, Eddie Cibrian, and her stepsons, Mason and Jake. She talked with People magazine in 2020 about how her blended family was getting along, revealing, "Nobody's fighting. Nobody's doing anything weird. It's interesting. The kids are older now. It's fun. The kids are happy, and that's all that matters." Shania Twain isn't just one of the most recognizable figures in country music, she's also one of the most inspiring. Her 1997 album Come On Over was so successful that it became the top-selling album from a female artist ever. Despite her massive success, she went on a 15-year recording hiatus, which she finally broke in 2017 with the album Now. Her long break wasn't exactly by choice, as she was suffering from complications from Lyme disease that led to vocal cord paralysis. She told The Guardian in 2018 that she thought she'd never sing again, but she refused to give up and she kept working to strengthen her voice, undergoing a surgery to reconstruct her voice box in 2018.
When you're a singer and it's your voice, it is just a terrible, terrible feeling.
During this time, Twain also turned her attention to other outlets. In 2011, she released the memoir From This Moment On and announced a 2-year Las Vegas residency. Her comeback is proof of the tenacity she has that makes her one of country music's biggest icons. Vince Gill has been on the country scene for decades. He joined the band Pure Prairie League in 1976, and 4 years later, one of the songs he penned for the group, Let Me Love You Tonight, hit number one. In 1983, he started a solo career and also worked as a guitarist for other country stars like Reba McEntire and Bonnie Raitt. He remained successful in the following decades, but he hasn't limited himself to country music. In 2017, he joined the rock band The Eagles, telling Pop Matters that he was beyond flattered to be asked to take over for their former frontman, Glenn Frey.
How do you feel about that?
Well, it's pretty surreal. You know, yeah. I couldn't be more grateful that they thought of me.
In 2019, Gill dove into some heavy topics with his album Okie, in which he sang about subjects like abuse and teenage pregnancy. He revealed that his song Forever Changed was about a teacher who touched him inappropriately when he was in middle school. He told Rolling Stone, "There is so much shame. If you speak out, you are persecuted. I wanted to speak out for innocence." Keith Urban has always been one of the coolest country stars on the scene, and that hasn't changed as he's gotten older. He released his first album in 1991, and he's been going strong ever since. He's certainly accomplished more than enough for one lifetime. He's won multiple Grammys, he served as a judge on American Idol, and he's been married to actress Nicole Kidman since 2006. Urban says he still has a lot to accomplish, though, and he has no intention of slowing down. In a 2019 interview with iHeartRadio, he was asked if he ever thinks about retiring one day. He joked that he will retire after Mick Jagger does, which he made sure to note is never going to happen. He also said that he doesn't look at music as something to retire from, because he loves making it. It's hard to believe that Kellie Pickler is still the same person who competed on American Idol in 2006. While she didn't come away with the title, she did finish in sixth place and soon landed a record deal. She released her first album, Small Town Girl, that same year. Since then, she's enjoyed an incredibly successful career. In addition to several more albums, she won Dancing with the Stars in 2013. She's also become a TV mainstay, starring on the reality series I Love Kellie Pickler and hosting Pickler and Ben. Pickler has also shown off her acting chops on more than one occasion, as she has a growing list of credits under her belt. She's appeared in several Hallmark movies, including Christmas at Graceland and The Mistletoe Secret. She told the Atlanta Journal-Constitution that she would love to continue to build her acting career if the right opportunities happen to come along in the future.
All right, this is going to be pretty exciting because you're like the happiest.
200 points! Check out one of our newest videos right here, plus even more list videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.